Hello, everybody. My name is Philippe Coquard. I'm the winemaker for Wollersheim Winery and Cedar Creek Winery. Today, we will be decanting a wine, and it is part of our story from the ground to the glass, explaining how to decant and why to decant. Any aged wine will need some decanting, and aged wine is over 5 years to 10 years in the bottle. Those wines that deserve aging can and most likely will have settled in the bottle, and you will have a line of sediment. And I do not want to disturb this bottle too much, but opposite of the front label, you will have a line of sediment. The sediment are nothing to worry about. They are a natural process. They are tannins, anthocyanin, red pigmentation, which over time will settle into the bottle. You have to remove them and leave them behind, otherwise the wine might taste cloudy, bitter, rough, and dirty. So decanting is something you have to plan for. Prior to a grand occasion, you want to drink an aged wine. You will take it out of your wine cellar, gently remove it. You will raise the bottle to a light and see the sediment, the line of sediment, and quite often it is a lot or just a little bit, but it's still nice to decant that wine. I'm going to talk to you about our tools that we are using today. Fairly simple. You need a decanter. It could be a fancy carafe. Could be fancier than this one, but this will do. Make sure it is bigger than the content of the bottle, because once you are pouring, you have to go extremely smoothly without jerking the bottle back and forth. So you have to do it without interruption. A flashlight is fine. You can use a candle, but a flashlight is a lot more practical. A bottle, a nice bottle opener, and a foil cutter. Sometimes you have the wax to remove, so you can cut, I would cut the entire wax, or you can go through the wax and open it that way. It is nice to have a damp towel so you can clean the neck of the bottle. That is the part where you will have to have the light go through. And sometimes there is some mold or dust underneath the capsule. So here we are going to cut the top, insert it right in the middle of the cork, and again without shaking the bottle, because you do not want to disturb the sediment at the bottom. Well, it appears that we are having some cork issue, which is kind of a normal case, and it does happen on older wines. In this case, I had to undo it from this style of opener and going by hand at an angle to make sure I would get the entire cork, and as a result, we do have some little pieces of corks that have fallen through the hole and are floating on top of the wine. I did provide myself with a filter on this decanter, and it will help filtering the pieces of cork, which is not a big deal at all, you know. So at this point, I will finish to remove the cork, or what's left of it. Okay. And there's very little, yeah, it is indeed crumbly, and smells fine. It smells good as an old wine. You can even smell the oak from aging. So at this moment, I will turn the flashlight on and I will start the decanting process, remembering that the sediment are right down in this corner. So without shaking the bottle, and it will have to be one motion. So I'm going to grab the bottle nice and firm this way, bring the decanter, put myself over the light, and start very slowly. And that is just right. So I'm pouring slowly, making sure everything works good. I will be watching for the sediment to come through. And you have to go slow and careful, especially towards the end. Few little pieces are coming through, which is okay. All right, we are seeing a little bit of haze coming through right now. Okay, now it's getting black. So that's where I will pull this. And as you can tell, there is very little left. Very little left in the bottle. Some of the sediment already on top that have stuck to the glass. And this, you will be surprised, is not that much. And you can see it's kind of a black mud. And that is a concentration of tannin, anthocyanin, red pigmentation that is not very pleasant to drink. It is the rough part of what's left from aging. One advice I would give you is to go to the sink, rinse this bottle, and you can put the wine back in the same bottle. So when you bring the wine to your guest, at least they know what they are drinking. It works either way. You can use it from the decanter, but it's better if you bring the bottle to the table. So, and at this moment, it is time to check out the good stuff. And wow, this is beautiful. This is the color you expect of older red wine. It's garnet, you know. All the blue, all the red pigmentation has died off, settled. This is good. So this is Domaine Reserve 1994, and with a nice piece of venison roast. Santé, and thank you for watching our decanting segment of From the Ground to the Glass. Thank you. Mighty good.